in this video, I will show you how to make four types of whole wheat paratha, roti, lachha paratha, and tandoori roti. It is very easy to make it, and you just need to follow this recipe. To start with, we need to make a perfect dough for a whole wheat roti. For that, I am taking some flour. I am using a hand mixer to knead the dough. You can use your hand as well. Add a little bit of water and keep kneading the dough. So on the hand mixer, I am adding water slow and steady so that the dough should be smooth enough, but you can also use your hands, it's your either choice. Now the whole wheat flour is binding together and becoming a dough, and you see that now the dough is not sticking on the side. And now it becomes a one ball. It means that the dough is almost ready. And this dough should not be too tight or too loose. So it has to be as a perfect consistency. So once it's done, so almost this dough is done. So once it's done, then we will add some oil into it, 1 to 2 spoons. And cover the dough with the oil and press a little bit of dough. So the dough should be the soft like this to make a perfect roti, and leave aside for 30 minutes. To start with, I will show you how to make roti first. Take a little bit of dough, roll the dough on your hand palms, put some flour, roll it, and then spread it with the roller. You can use your island or you can use a cutting board to roll the roti. I'm using a chakla and the belan to make the roti. This step is very important. You can use either the non-stick pan or any kind of pan to make your roti. And it should not be too hot or too cold. It has to be heated enough to make a roti. And when you put the roti onto the tawa or pan, you have to flip first very fast when it is become a little brown. Now I'm checking a roti. When one side is done, only then I will flip. Now I see the bubbles and see the roti. Now I flip it and I take some cloth or the kitchen cloth and press the roti very gently. The roti is filled with the steam and got puffed, and you need to ensure that you have to cook on all the sides, on the sides as well. This is how you can make a perfect roti, and which is very soft. The second one is to make a plain paratha. For the paratha, I am taking a little bit more dough than the roti. Roll it on your hand palms and use some flour to spread it. Then once it's spread the same as the roti, then you have to add the oil into it. I am using olive oil. Spread the oil and flip it and make a square. Then use the flour and spread it with the roller to make a square shape. This is a paratha shape. Then add to the pan or tawa. Once it's done, and then you can flip it. Then you can add the oil onto it. Then put the oil on the other side. Then with the help of spatula, press it to cook nicely on all the ends. This is how you can make your paratha, and now your paratha is ready. The third is the lachha paratha, or you can make the lachha paratha. The same way I am taking a dough, roll on your hand palms. Use the flour to spread it with the ruler. Once you spread it, add the oil onto it. Then cut the roti till middle and roll on your finger. When rolling, ensure the oil side should be inside of the roll. Then turn it. And now with the use of roller, spread it. The lachha paratha is a little thicker than the roti, like the same thickness as a paratha. Roll it and then add to the tawa or a pan. When the color changes, it means it's done on the one side. Then flip it. Then cook on from both the sides. Once done, add the oil over it. Maybe you can use butter as well, and crush it. Now the layer of the lachha paratha, you can see. This is how you can make the lachha paratha. The last one, I will show you how to make tandoori roti. For this, definitely we need the iron tawa, and you need to ensure there is no oil on the iron tawa, which I cleaned already. Take a dough, roll it on your hand palms. Use the flour, flatten it, and make a roti with the roller. Tandoori roti should be a little thick than the regular roti. Now add the water on one side of the roti. The water helps in the binding onto the iron tawa. Then flip the water side on the tawa. Now wait until the roti is cooked on the one side. The color of the roti will change and will have some air bubbles. So once it's cooked on the one side, like as shown, to cook on the another side, I will flip the tawa on the heat. Whether you can use the gas stove or the electric stove, the method is the same. So see how the you can cook from another side. The roti is ready. Now I am going to take it out from the tawa. This is how it looks from the back side. Add some oil or butter onto the roti. I am adding the olive oil, and it is good to serve. If you like my recipes, please don't forget to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon to get the updates on my videos.